And the idea that this is a racist country, as distinct from a country that sometimes has some racism in it, is the kind of area that I find fascinating. Do you think the UK is inherently racist?
Yeah, to be honest, and I know that will maybe sound surprising. I think that all of the Western world is inherently racist. But the reason I don't normally say that out loud is because as soon as you use the R word, as soon as you use the word racist, all sorts of defences spring up, and we end up having a different conversation. I heard some of the stuff you were just saying about you've never met a racist. That's because you think of for a lot of people, when you say racist, you know, a pointy hood wearing, cross burning.
Yes, you know, I mean, obviously, yeah. I don't know any of those either, by the way.
Yeah, but instead of, okay, the person who's a perfectly lovely guy but doesn't think that that sort of person fits well into his office and wouldn't really want his daughter going out with that kind of person. It's not about race, it's more about, you know, where they're from or what they look like or sort of music they listen to. And, you know, that sort of, I would still say racist, but you might say, oh, no, that's just someone, you know, who's got particular, particular things or doesn't.
Well, it could be, but is that, I mean, is it, it's interesting because you're bang on in what you say. Obviously, I did acknowledge in that little rant that, you know, there's subconscious racism, there's all sorts of other things. It doesn't mean you're walking around with a burning cross. I do get that. But simultaneously, if you're a person that doesn't have any of those isms about them, and you hear somebody say, this is a racist country, and you think, well, I'm not racist. I couldn't give a flying what's it, what somebody's background or colour is. Then that becomes rather insulting. So when somebody says your whole country is racist, I mean, if I went to Nigeria, for example, as a white bloke, I'd probably really find out what racism looked like. If you speak to any white person that's lived or been in Nigeria, it's a hellhole in that respect. You ain't about to get yourself a seat at the top table there anytime soon. So we don't have that issue here, do we?
You're opening up massive cans of worms. We could talk about Nigeria.
I'd imagine
that the white minority there is in considerably better an economic position than the black minority here.
Yeah, by definition of going there to really work. But I mean, if I went there to live and decided I wanted to start my life in Lagos tomorrow, I reckon that might be a bit of a struggle.
You'd probably be better off than most of the Lagos-born people, I would imagine. But that's,
you think so?
There's a much, that's a much.
It's a wider argument. Just give us an idea then, Maurice. I mean, I know it's such a massive conversation. But how would you articulate then to a white person and a largely white audience how would you define what a racist country is? And what's the difference between racism and people who just make choices? For example, if somebody said, I'm white, I'd rather not marry a black girl or date a black girl. That doesn't make you racist, because there's plenty of black people who don't want to date a white person. That's just a ethnic choice. And for some people, they think it's rather a healthy choice as well.
Sure. Okay, so the way I try to go about it, because like I say, I try and have these conversations a lot, and they're often quite difficult because people straight away jump to, oh my God, I'm not me, that's not me, I don't think like that. That's not the point. It's trying to step away. When we talk about systemic, or when you say Britain is a institutionally racist country, it doesn't mean every single British person is a racist. It means the things that happen in Britain disproportionately impact on people that are black. So it means, you know, why do black people get stopped and searched more, arrested more, locked up more, you know, why their sentence is longer. You can go through almost any strand of British life, and there's a negative impact if you happen to be black. Now, that's what I mean by the institution of Britain being racist. It doesn't mean that every British person is walking around trying to undermine black people, or, you know, I would think almost any person that watched George Floyd died, any person would have been upset and offended by that, I would like to think. And so it's not at all saying that the whole nation is racist. I think that's where the conversation often gets derailed, because we get into a defensive thing. Well, it shouldn't be about that. It's about us all learning, growing and moving forward together.
Good work. Maurice, I hope we speak again. again. It's been lovely. Thank you, sir. Maurice McLeod, social commentator, director of